Hello, this is Clyde J. Kale, and welcome to episode 15 of Clyde's Art Story. With this episode, I have a guest, an artist friend of mine, Constance Bronson. Hello, Constance.
Hi. Hi, Clyde. How you doing?
Just fine. Hey, welcome to the show. Let's get started right away. Constance, how long have you been an artist, professional or otherwise?
I've been an artist all my life, but professionally, I've been a jewelry artist for 12 years, and before that I was a portrait artist for a while, and just a struggling artist for about 5 or 6 years before that, you know. So.
Okay, so you've got a good deal of experience there.
Started painting when I was in my teens, and drawing before that.
Okay, what kind of art do you create? You mentioned jewelry. How would you describe yourself as to what kind of artist are you and what kind of art you create?
Through the years, I have started painting as a just regular art, just, you know, local colors. And then I went to painting in a full color, which is not local color, but it's seeing light and color in a different way. And in a impressionistic style. So it's a lot more colorful, and it's just gives a more vibrant painting. Since I started making jewelry, I did not paint for almost 10 years. So then I went to, it's a long time. So after I started painting again, I decided to, which has always been one of my great, I love abstracts. So I decided to start painting abstracts. I'd always painted some abstracts, but never really fully went into abstracts as a painting medium or style.
Okay. Now what medium is this? Is this oil or acrylic, watercolor or mixed? Or?
I've always painted in oils. So the acrylics have been a new medium for me that I've started painting in since I started painting again. I still like to paint in oils, but I've decided to start in the acrylics. The acrylics have really changed in the last 10 years, and they're really nice to work with now.
Yeah, they really improved the technology since they first came out. They're pretty much, I prefer acrylics, and
they were not very viscous when I was trying to paint with them before, over 10 years ago. But now the quality is very nice.
Yes, so it's very exceptional.
I use them now.
What is your vision or your desire for your art?
I would like to continue making jewelry and just get more creative and get more complicated and delve into the smithing side of jewelry. Just really challenge myself as far as the jewelry goes. And with painting, I would just like to just seriously have fun with my heart and soul and just see where it takes me, you know, just
sounds like a wonderful journey.
Yeah, just play around with my spirit and see where it takes me, because I love to paint. I always have.
Where do you see yourself in the future with your art? I mean, would you like to have gallery representation, or have some of your pieces end up in a museum somewhere, or one of the high-class museums, you know, in Chicago or New York? Or you have any ambition for that?
I would love to be represented by a gallery or two. And eventually, it would be nice to have a museum representation. But I think every artist would like to have that. If that happens, that would be great. If it doesn't, it's not a big deal. For me, being an artist makes my soul happy. So that's what I like to do. And if somebody else enjoys it, then that would be great also. For me, my paintings and my art hanging around in my house, they're like my jewels to look at. So that's how I see it. While I'm here on Earth, I like to enjoy them myself. So,
do you have an email address so people can get a hold of you?
Yes, I do. It's golfcreature@yahoo.com.
Okay, say that one more time.
golfcreature@yahoo.com.
Okay. And you have a website?
Yes, I have the Itsy website, which is itsy.com/shop/cbrosnans.
Okay. And you have a you have a Wix website too, don't you? What's that address?
That address is cbrosnanart.com
or?
Yeah, .com.
Okay.
Sorry about that.
Yeah, it's always good to get that .com in there because, you know, yeah. Nowadays you can use a .art or .org.
Right.
Or,
yeah, that's know. True.
Okay, now, we were talking earlier, and you've got some exciting events coming up here. You want to talk about that? What's coming up in October?
October, I have been accepted into the Affair of the Heart shows, Oklahoma City and in Tulsa. So in October, it will be the Oklahoma City show on the 19th and 20th and 21st. And then in November, it will be the Tulsa show, November 16th through 18th.
Do you have a booth number?
The one in Oklahoma City is 798. And the November show is booth number 342.
And now, are you going to be, is this going to display your paintings, or is this just your jewelry? Or
yes, this is the jewelry.
Constance, it's been nice talking with you, and I really wish you success at your Affair of the Heart show. Now, folks, remember that in Oklahoma City, the Affair of the Heart, it's going to be at the State Fairgrounds. She'll be there on the 19th, 20th, and 21st. And then she'll also be up in Tulsa. So if you're in the Oklahoma City or the Tulsa area, please drop by and say hi to Constance. Constance, thank you so much for being my guest with this episode of Clyde's Art Story.
Thank you, Clyde.
And that was a wonderful interview with my artist friend, Constance Bronson. Thank you so much for listening to episode 15 of Clyde's Art Story. And if you're interested in more episodes, please send me an email, cjkale@mystery-otr.com. And for past episodes of Clyde's Art Story, please visit my YouTube channel. That's youtube.com/cjkale. Previous episodes of Clyde's Art Story, and also future episodes will be posted there for your enjoyment. Again, thank you so much for watching and listening to Clyde's Art Story. Bye-bye.